The first problem is related with op-amp circuit, again figure shown in figure circuit diagram. And in this circuit diagram, we directly find out the which type of circuit is this. So according to the approach, first find out what is given and what is asked. So the find out output will is here, and after observation, which to hello,
yes, sir. Yes,
hello, hello,
hello, hello,
yes, sir.
Okay, then okay. स्क्रीन पे दिख रहा है क्या आपको?
नो सर,
ब्लैंक दिख रहा है।
ब्लैंक क्यों आ रहा है? अभी दिख रहा है?
यस सर, यस।
ओके, अगेन वी स्टार्ट। So figure shows both input of inverting and non-inverting configuration of this op-amp. Now the question is asked, that is find out the output voltage. We find out here output voltage. Before that, we observe the input is given to the inverting and non-inverting terminal of op-amp. So first find out the output of inverting terminal and output of the non-inverting terminal. So our explanation is that the output due to the inverting and the output due to the non-inverting terminal. So the output due to the inverting terminal, again we go for the gain, that is a input voltage. First we have multiplied with the gain, that is gain of the inverting amplifier is minus RF by R1. So RF is a 2k, that is a 2 kilo ohm, and R1 is 1 kilo ohm. So input voltage multiplied by minus RF by R1, so minus 2k by 1k, and the input voltage is 1 volt, which is given as input side. 1 volt is given, okay? So the multiplication or the output voltage due to the inverting input is minus 2 volt, because 2k by 1k is 2k, and the minus sign is related with it, and k cancel. So the output voltage with respect to inverting input is minus 2 volt. Same, we find out the output voltage with respect to the non-inverting terminal. Now the non-inverting terminal is having the gain 1 plus RF by R1. And the voltage divider rule is applied. Why? The reason behind is there is a network of 1 kilo ohm is before input at the node V1. So hence we find out the V1 output voltage before entering into the non-inverting terminal. So the output due to the non-inverting input is V1 into the gain. So V1 into 1 plus RF by R1. So first find out the V1. What is the V1? At what voltage present at V1 side, V1 node? So because of the voltage divider network of 1 kilo ohm and another 1 kilo ohm, the output voltage V1 is getting. So 1K multiplied by 1 by 1K plus 1K. That is the voltage divider rule is resistance, another resistance divided by the network resistance, total network resistance addition. So 1K divided by 1K plus 1K. So it is a 1K by 2K. So KK cancels, so 1 by 2. So the 1 by 2 is 0.5 volt. So V1, which is given to the non-inverting terminal, is 0.5 volt. So 0.5 into the gain, that gain is 1 plus RF by R1. So RF is 2K and R1 is 2K, so 2K by 1K. So it's a 2K. So 1 plus 2K is 3K. So 0.5 into 3 is equals to 1.5 volt. So the inverting terminal voltage is minus 2 volt and non-inverting terminal voltage is 1.5 volt. After adding this, the total output voltage we are getting, so V0 is equal to minus 2 volt plus 1.5 volt. So minus 0.5 volt is the final answer. And according to our MCQ, that is the option A, B, C, D. C option is minus 0.5 volt. So our option answer is option number C. Clear? Understand? We separate out this problem by inverting terminal voltage and non-inverting terminal voltage. Clear? Anyone? Any confusion? Hello?
No, sir.
Understand?
Yes, sir.
Now we go for second problem. The second problem, again, read the statement according our strategy. The component in the circuit shown below are ideal. If the op amp is in positive feedback and the input voltage Vi is a sine wave of amplitude 1 volt, the output voltage V0 is. So given thing is a sine wave is given and the amplitude of that sine wave is 1 volt peak to peak. That is a 1 volt positive side and 1 volt negative side. So that sine wave is also drawn in the circuit and circuit also given. So what is the output voltage? So first find out the circuit. What type of circuit is there? Circuit positive terminal of op amp is grounded and negative terminal having a VI input, that is a sine wave. So circuit in the configuration of inverting configuration. Okay. Now the sine wave is given. So sine wave input is 1 volt. And how to write? How we write the sine wave is given, how to that equation is right. So equation is given, that is V1 is equal to 1 sine omega t volt. That 1 represent the Vm. So our standard equation is V1 is equal to Vm sine omega t. So Vm is 1 volt because the amplitude of this wave is 1 volt peak to peak. So Vm is equal to 1 volt. That's why the equation becomes V1 is equal to 1 sine omega t volts. Now the find out we output voltage we find out here from the equation. Now this circuit diagram is related with Schmitt trigger. Now the Schmitt trigger is particularly made up for a square wave generator. It is called as a square wave generator. Whatever input is given, it generates a square wave. So according to Schmitt trigger, we find out here lower threshold voltage and the upper threshold voltage. VTL is a lower threshold voltage and VTH is a higher threshold voltage. Okay. Now for threshold voltage, the voltage swing voltage is very important. That is a positive and negative voltage swing. That is called as a voltage saturation, which is given at plus 5 volt and minus 5 volt. Okay. Now this threshold voltage for above circuit is find out by using the formula, that is a lower threshold voltage. So it is given as VTL is equal to minus VSAT. Minus VSAT means threshold voltage, lower threshold voltage. Minus VSAT into R1 by R2. R1 means 1 kilo ohm and R2 means the feedback resistance. So R1 is 1 and R2 is also 1. Okay. So after putting the value, the VTL, that is the lower threshold voltage, is minus 5, that is a 5 volt into 1k by 1k. So it's a minus 5 volt. Same, we find out the upper threshold voltage, which is positive, that is a VTH. That is a positive saturation voltage. So plus VSAT into R1 by R2. So again, R1 and R2 value is same. So it's 1. And plus VSAT is 5 volt. So VTH, that is upper threshold voltage, is 5 volt. Now here, VTL and VTH goes beyond the input value, because input voltage is plus minus 1 volt. Whatever sine wave is given, its amplitude is plus volt, plus 1 volt and minus 1 volt. So whether the input is 1 plus minus 1 volt, but output goes plus 5 volt and minus 5 volt. So according to this, this circuit not act as a Schmitt trigger, because the output voltage is beyond the limit of input voltage. So it cannot convert input sine wave into square wave. So limitation of this circuit is, whatever Schmitt trigger is performing the operation, whatever input is given, it performs the square wave generator. So it generates a square wave output. But here, the output is beyond the limit, because input is plus minus 1 volt according to our sine wave, but the output we are getting, VTL and VTH, is plus minus 5 volt. So our Schmitt trigger not perform the operation of square wave generator. So in the above circuit, there is no scope for the output to change from plus VSAT, plus 5 volt, to minus 5 volt. And hence, our output is option number B, that is a plus minus 5 volt. Okay, understand? Anyone? Kunal? Aryan? Hello? Hello? हेलो
यस सर
समझ गया प्रॉब्लम समझ गया
यस सर
ओके आई प्रोसीड नाउ दिस इज द थर्ड प्रॉब्लम इन द सर्किट बिलो ऑल द कंपोनेंट्स आर आइडियल सो फाइंड आउट द करंट आई zero, that is a load current. Now in the above circuit, it is in the configuration, because the inverting terminal of op amp is grounded through 1 kilo ohm, and input is given to the positive terminal of op amp, Vi. We again redraw circuit and give the node, and after noting the node, that is Vn, Vp and the direction of current, we solve this problem. Now Vp and Vn. The Vn is here grounded. So from the virtual short or virtual ground concept, Vp is at Vi, because at node of positive terminal, non-inverting terminal of op amp, Vi is equal to Vp. So when Vi is equal to Vp, so Vn is equal to Vi also. So according to the ground or virtual ground concept or virtual short, the same, Vn is equal to Vp is equal to Vi. Here we apply KCL at node N. When we are applying KCL at node N, so I1 flowing through the R1 is equal to the I2 flowing through the RF. So according to our KCL, we transform it into Ohm's law. So input voltage is grounded. So 0 minus Vn divided by R1 equals to Vn minus V0 divided by RF. Here value of R1 is 1K and value of RF is also 1K. But we know that output voltage is because input is given to the non-inverting terminal of op-amp. So V0 is equal to the gain into Vi. So gain is 1 plus RF by R1 into Vi. But RF and R1 are 1K. So 1K, 1K cancel. So 1 plus 1 is 2. So V0 is equal to 2 Vi. The same KCL is applied at output terminal where is the node O. It is denoted as node O. Here the I2 and I0 are incoming current. I0 and I2 are the incoming current and outgoing current is IL. So I2 plus I0 is equal to IL. So by transforming again it into in the Ohm's law, I2 becomes Vn minus V0 divided by resistance plus I0 is equal to V0 by RL. Now again V0 is 2 Vi. So we put V0 value. So Vn is equal to again according to the virtual short concept is Vi. So Vi minus 2 Vi into R value divided by 1K plus I0 is equal to 2 Vi divided by 1K. So sort this equation, that is V0 is equal to 2 volt and Vn is equal to Vi. So we directly get the value of I0, that is a load current, which is Vi divided by 1K. So 3 into Vi, value of Vi is 2 volt divided by 1K. So 6 divided by 10 raised to the power 3. So load current I0 becomes 6 milliampere because 10 raised to the power 3 jo denominator mein tha jo numerator mein chala jayega to 10 raised to the power minus 3 ho jayega. So I0 is equal to 6 milliampere. Understand? Hello? 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 Hello?
Yes, sir.
समझ रहे हैं ना?
हाँ सर.
बच्चे रिस्पॉन्ड क्यों नहीं कर रहे?
नहीं सर.
हेलो.
यस सर.
एनी प्रॉब्लम? एनी प्रॉब्लम? कुछ प्रॉब्लम है क्या?
सर एक बार और बता दो सर.
हाँ बढ़ो ना आगे. आप रिस्पॉन्ड कीजिए.
नहीं आया
क्या बोले? Now this is the problem number 4. In the circuit shown below, all the components are ideal and the input voltage is sinusoidal. The magnitude of steady state output voltage V0. Okay. Before question solving, first I tell you, this circuit diagram is divided into two parts. The first part of the circuit is, that is a capacitor and diode D1. It make itself positive clamper, and the diode D2 and capacitor, second capacitor C2, it create positive peak detector. I redraw circuit below. You observe this. The 230 volt RMS voltage is given as a supply voltage, and how we find out the output voltage here? The directly formula is given. Because this circuit combinedly, that is a positive clamper and positive peak detector, combinedly work as a voltage doubler circuit, means double the voltage, whatever input is given. So output voltage formula is given, V0 is equal to 2 into peak value of the input voltage. Now, what is the peak value of the input voltage? Observe, the input voltage is 230 volt RMS. So first find out the peak value of input voltage, that is Vp is equal to 230 into under root 2, because it is RMS, root mean square. So that's why we multiply 230 with under root 2. So output voltage V0 is equal to 2 into 230 under root 2. So directly get through the calculation, that is a V0 is equal to 650 into 538 volts. So this is the correct option. Such type of problem if asking, so you directly apply the formula, that is output voltage is equal to 2 into peak value of input voltage. And if the peak value of input voltage is indicating 230, multiply with 230 volts. But if the RMS value is given, so we multiply Vp into 230 directly. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Understand?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, problem number 5. In the circuit shown below, what is the output voltage Vout? If a silicon transistor Q and an ideal op amp are used. Now the circuit shown, it is again operational amplifier where positive terminal of op amp is grounded. Input is given to the negative terminal, that is input is 5 volt through the 1 kilo ohm resistor. And after observing that there is no any feedback resistor. Instead of feedback resistor, मुझे feedback resistor की जगह पे transistor Q connect किया, whose base is grounded, emitter is connected to the output side, and collector is connected to the negative terminal of op amp, and the input is given to the that terminal. So after observation, for the given ideal op amp, negative terminal will be grounded. यानी negative terminal क्या किया है? वो भी non-inverting terminal ground में connect किया. Okay? So the collector terminal of BJT will be at 0 voltage. According to the virtual ground concept, if the positive terminal of op amp is grounded, so the its negative terminal also considered as ground. So that's why the collector of transistor Q is considered as ground. So collector voltage VC is 0 volt. Clear? So when VC is 0 volt, but the it carrying current, because input voltage 5 volt is given. So current from 1 kilo ohm is given by, how find out current? I is equal to V by R. So what is V? V is 5 volt minus 0 divided by resistance, that is 1K. So I, that is current I flowing through the 1K is 5 milliampere. This current will flow completely through the BJT. अब ये जो करंट है आई, ये पूरा कहां से जाएगा? अपना ट्रांजिस्टर से, जो हम क्यू से इंडिकेट कर रहे हैं. ये क्यों ऑप एम में नहीं जाएगा? क्योंकि ऑप एम का जो इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस होता है आ रहा है वो क्या होता है, इनफाइनाइट होता है. सो टोटल करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द बीजेटी, बिकॉज नो करंट विल फ्लो इनटू द आइडियल ऑप एम, एंड द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस इज इनपुट रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ आइडियल ऑप एम इज इनफाइनाइट. सो फॉर बीजेटी वी हैव कलेक्टर करंट. अभी बीजेटी के हिसाब से कलेक्टर करंट क्या है, जीरो है. बेस करंट हमको दिख रहा है जीरो है, क्योंकि बेस वीबी का है, ग्राउंड में कनेक्ट है. और हमारे पास कलेक्टर करंट क्या है, 5 मिली एम्पियर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस द बेस कलेक्टर जंक्शन इज रिवर्स बायस, यानी बेस कलेक्टर जंक्शन क्या हो गया, रिवर्स बायस, दैट इज जीरो वोल्टेज. देयरफॉर द कलेक्टर करंट आईसी कैन हैव ओनली ई बेस इमिटर इज फॉरवर्ड बायस. यानी अगर बेस इमिटर कलेक्टर जंक्शन रिवर्स बायस है, जीरो है, तो हमको ट्रांजिस्टर को अगर ऑन करना है या कलेक्टर करंट को फ्लो करना है तो कौन सा जंक्शन काम में आएगा, सिर्फ ट्रांजिस्टर ऑन करने के लिए बेस इमिटर जंक्शन. अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस सिलिकॉन, इफ कंसिडर दिस इज सिलिकॉन मटेरियल, सो बेस इमिटर जंक्शन या ट्रांजिस्टर को ऑन करने के लिए कितना वोल्टेज लगता है, 0.7 वोल्ट. So VBE is we consider 0.7 volt. So VBE is base minus emitter, that is 0.7. Here we know that base voltage is zero. So V voltage is directly getting towards V out, because here see V is connected to the output V out. So V is equals to V out and VB is equal to zero. So after putting VB is equal to zero and V is equal to V out, our output voltage is equal to 0.7 volt, so V out is equal to minus 0.7 volt. So V out is equal to minus 0.7. Consider, understand? समझ गया? चला प्रोसीड. हाँ बोलते जाओ, फिर से मैं बाहर निकलता हूं तो वो अटक जाता है. अंडरस्टैंड? हेलो 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 हेलो. प्रॉब्लम नंबर 6, इन द सर्किट ऑफ द फिगर वी जीरो, वी फाइंड आउट द वी जीरो हियर, एंड दिस सर्किट having a positive feedback because negative terminal of op amp is grounded, positive terminal having a input, and feedback is also giving from the positive terminal of op amp. So in positive feedback, is it working as a op amp in saturation region, and the input applied voltage is positive, so whatever input is given plus 1 volt is not considered as a output voltage. So a positive voltage is a positive saturation voltage. So how we find out the positive saturation voltage? So voltage, we consider here a voltage swing, and this voltage swing is plus 15 volt and minus 15 volt. So our answer is D, that is plus 15 volt, because in the circuit they find out output voltage V0 and input is given to the non-inverting terminal. So whatever output generated is positive, it is in phase and positive saturation voltage, and the positive saturation voltage is given plus 15 volts. Output of this circuit is plus 15 volts. Now next, problem 7. In the differential amplifier of the figure, if the source resistance of the current source IEEE is infinite, then the common mode gain is. Now we know that this circuit is a differential amplifier circuit having a transistor T1 or Q1 and Q2, एंड दे फाइंड आउट द कॉमन मोड गेन. नो द कॉमन मोड गेन इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय ए इंटू आर सी डिवाइडेड बाय आर डबल ई. Since source resistance of the current source is infinite, if the R double E is infinite, anything divided by infinite, यानी किसी को भी आप infinite से divide करोगे तो क्या आएगा? Output zero आएगा. So according to the formula, common mode gain AC is equal to A R C divided by zero or infinite. So output AC is zero. Output AC is zero. So common mode gain is zero. So option number A is correct. Clear? Understand? Anyone? Here AC divided by infinite is there, not zero. Okay? So output is zero. Problem number 8. The circuit below implement a filter between the input current II and output voltage. The op amp is ideal. So what type of filter is implemented? Circuit is given. कौन सा प्रकार का फिल्टर जनरेट होगा? So from the circuit we know that having R and L, and while we are going for explanation, then we consider the filter. Then there is a omega and XC or XL, but there is an inductive component, so XL is there. So in the explanation, when frequency is zero, XL or omega L is zero. So upper branch is open circuited, and when the upper branch is open circuited, it is not in the figure. So again we redraw the figure. So under such condition, output voltage is zero. So at low frequency output voltage is zero, but when at high frequencies, when omega is infinite, so XL is very large, and again we circuit redraw. The circuit having a L path is shorted. L path is shorted. So whatever output voltage V0 is getting, that is R1 into I1. So at low frequency output voltage is zero, and at high frequency output voltage is R1 into I1. So circuit वर्क एज अ हाई पास फिल्टर, यानी लो फ्रीक्वेंसी पे आउटपुट जीरो होता है और हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी पे आउटपुट मिलता है. सो लो फ्रीक्वेंसी को कट कर रहा है, हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी को पास कर रहा है. दैट्स व्हाई दिस सर्किट वर्क एज अ हाई पास फिल्टर. सो ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज करेक्ट. अंडरस्टैंड? क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. जो सर्किट इज गिवन, the given ideal operational amplifier circuit shown in the figure indicate the correct transfer characteristic assuming ideal diode with zero cut-in voltage. Now the circuit is given having D1 and D2 and a positive terminal of op-amp having a 2 kilo ohm and 5 kilo ohm and 2 kilo ohm voltage divider network through the diode D1 and D2. In the option, there are 4 options, and we find out which option is correct. So before that, we find out which path is in circuit. So first we find out the threshold voltage after considering the first path, that is the diode D1 and resistor 0.5 kilo. So only one diode will be on condition when lower diode is on condition, what output voltage is generated. So output voltage VU is equal to voltage divider rule, that is R1 upon R1 plus R2 into VSAT. So first we consider 2 kilo ohm divided by addition of 2 and 5 kilo, 0.5 kilo ohm. So 2K plus 0.5K, it is 2.5K into VSAT. So here saturation voltage is 10, that is positive saturation voltage. So 2 into 10 by 2.5, so output voltage is 8 volt. And when upper diode is on, upper diode means related with 2 kilo ohm. So again, same formula we are right. So R1 डिवाइडेड बाय आर वन प्लस आर टू मल्टीप्लाइड बाय वी सेट. सो आर वन प्लस आर टू दैट इज अ 2 किलो ओम प्लस 2 किलो ओम दैट इज 4 किलो ओम. सो 2 किलो ओम डिवाइडेड बाय 4 किलो ओम मल्टीप्लाइड बाय लोअर थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज दैट इज अ माइनस वी सेट विच इज माइनस 10. सो 2 × −10/4 आंसर इज −5. सो वी हैव अ अपर थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज एंड लोअर थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज दैट इज अ पॉजिटिव वोल्टेज एंड निगेटिव वोल्टेज. पॉजिटिव वोल्टेज इज 8 वोल्ट एंड निगेटिव वोल्टेज इज −5 वोल्ट. सो ऑब्जर्व विच फिगर इज रिलेटेड विथ इट. अपर थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज फिगर नंबर बी वेयर अपर थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज +5 वोल्ट प्लस 8 वोल्ट एंड लोअर थ्रेशोल्ड वोल्टेज इज −5 वोल्ट. सो दिस इज अ करेक्ट फिगर. सो ऑप्शन नंबर बी इज करेक्ट. क्लियर? अंडरस्टैंड? हेलो नाउ द लास्ट प्रॉब्लम. द आउटपुट वोल्टेज ऑफ द रेगुलेटेड पावर सप्लाय शोन इन फिगर. दिस इज द रेगुलेटेड पावर सप्लाय वेयर ऑपएम्प इज कनेक्टेड. नाउ द रेगुलेटेड पावर सप्लाय इज कनेक्टेड टू द झेनर डायोड. सो झेनर डायोड हैविंग अ 3 वोल्ट. If we see the figure, we find the voltage of non-inverting terminal. So, positive terminal of op-amp is connected to the output of zener. So, the positive terminal of op-amp having a 3 volt and it is indirectly connected to the negative terminal of op-amp. So, output is negative terminal of op-amp is 3 volt. So, whatever output generated by op-amp is 3 volt. So, at the negative terminal of op-amp, having the voltage divider network that is a 20 kilo ohm and 40 kilo ohm. So how we find out the output voltage? So we find out the output voltage using this voltage divider rule, that is 20 divided by 20 plus 40 into V0 is equal to output voltage is 3 volt. So 3, 1 by 3, V0 is equal to 3 volt. So 3 is transferred to right hand side. So the output voltage V0 is equal to 9 volt. So option number C is correct. Okay. Any queries here? In any question? Hello? Hello?
Hello? Yes, sir.
Any query? ऐसा है कि कुछ समझा नहीं कपिल?
ना सर.
कहीं confusion असेल तर सांगा. ठीक है ना?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.